You are able to see the screen right now. So you are able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So fine. So as already I told you, so now this course is, you know, just already. So this course is essentially, you know, CE7710. Okay, so advanced structural dynamics. Followed. So now I know already you people would have done structural dynamics and structural mechanics in your previous semesters. Then you know it will be easy to follow this course itself. Okay. Now coming to this syllabus, say okay. So something is already put up online, but you know I have slightly changed the syllabus you know to account for my our students and for my research itself. Okay. So we will be discussing essentially here you know about this numerical methods only. Okay. So now here I know the this course you know we will be focusing more on you know the wave propagation actually, okay, so which is slightly advanced than in your structural dynamics. Okay, so we will discuss you know how this finite difference method. Okay, so we will see this finite differences say how you know can be used to solve this wave propagations. Then we also will see finite element also. Essentially dynamics only, the finite element, you know, this itself. Then we also will see pseudo spectral methods actually, okay, of solving our equations kind of a thing. Then we also will see one very famous thing which is widely used in earth sciences nowadays is, you know, this is spectral element method actually, okay, so to solve this equations. So these are the methods, you know, which we are going to see in our course. So we will use all these, you know, the four methods itself to solve, you know, the wave propagation. Essentially, the wave propagation essentially whatever you studied in your advanced structural mechanics. Okay, so this is going to be our, you know, broadly about this the syllabus for this course. And of course, you know, we also will see some structural dynamics problems also, like multi-degree of freedom systems or something like that. Whatever you have studied in your dynamics, say. So we will see mostly is the numerical kind of thing or FEM kind of an approaches actually, okay, finite element or something. So what happens, you know, for these type of systems, you know, the beam or something, or it is something like, you know, finite element in structural dynamics kind of a thing. Okay, so how do you club these two? So this is a broad, you know, the outlook of this course. Now, if time permits, say, okay, in the end, you know, we may discuss about some, you know, the random vibrations actually. Okay. So, how to bring in randomness, you know, random vibration kind of a thing. So, here are some random fields, say, suppose if material properties are uncertain or something, how do we incorporate in computational methods essentially? Okay. How to solve, you know, these type of problems in finite element method itself. So these are the broad, you know, the three units of this course. So total about, you see, some 30 to 40 lectures, okay? So we will complete this syllabus itself, okay? And now in this course, you know, because it is more on the numerical methods, so instead of, you know, more emphasis is given on, you see, less teaching will be there, but more, you know, the assignments kind of a thing will be there. Okay, so where you people have to do, you know, lot of, you see, problems kind of a thing. And there may be, you can even select some projects also, followed. I may give some project kind of a thing. So you people have to take it and then, you know, solve kind of a thing. So less teaching will be there, but more, you know, implementation kind of a thing and other things are there. Okay. And now coming to this softwares. Okay, so we will be using not software. These are all what you can say is the computer codes. Okay, so we will be whatever I am going to teach. So you have to do some computer, you know, the codes are already available actually. Okay, so these codes, you know, you have to download and then you can see. So one is, you know, you have to go to this website, CIG website actually. Okay, so computational, you know, infrastructure in geodynamics kind of a thing. Now, so here you will get lot of, you know, the codes. Okay. For wave propagation, which you can use for a variety of you know, the things. Okay, so I will show you the website itself. Now, see if you go to this Firefox. Okay, so now if you go to this website, so all of you are able to see, right? This is geodynamics.org.
Yes, sir.
So now here if you go, this is a nice website, you know, for GeoDynamics. So you click on software, say, okay. So you will have a lot of softwares are there. See, one is, you know, there are several finite element codes are given there. Most of them have been written in Fortran language, or I think some of them have been written, I think, in C language also, okay. So mostly, you see, we will be doing this course. That is, you know, the Spectrum 3D Globe, say, okay. So this you have to, you followed, right? We will be using these type of codes actually. So this is like a, you know, a spectral element method, which you can solve. The whole globe itself is modeled here, and you know, it is in a finite element kind of a thing. So, you know, mass matrix, stiffness matrix, everything is there. So it solves actually. So you can use this code, can, you know, simulate really, you see, the earthquakes itself in real time, okay. So these are some of the code. One code is here. Then, you know, the spectrum. So here there are several things are there. Globe code is there. Cartesian, say, like Earth is a sphere. So when you do finite element model of a sphere, it is slightly different. And if you do for a Cartesian, say, like a cube kind of a thing, it's a different. Then we will be using this axis M, parallel spectral element code. Then, you know, this Spectrum 3D is there, Spectrum 1D. Now, apart from that, you see, we also will use this Pylith actually, okay, one more code. So this is a FEM code actually, okay. So which can solve, you know, the large domains kind of things. And then I will show you the finite difference also. Some codes are there, not in this website, you know, some other website is there. So all these codes, you know, you people have to run and get some results. So I will be teaching little bit of theory, how to run these codes and how to do this one. And you have to implement this, and you know, whatever the projects we give, so you have to complete and then submit, you see, all those results, okay. So this is how, you see, the code is going to be. It's more like a, you know, the practical kind of a case. So, you know, after this course, you should be able to, you know, implement your finite element or spectral element things, you know, very in an easy fashion, okay. So this is our course. Yeah. So this is how, you see, so that is a website. So all of you can go to that website. You can download this course itself. And another thing is, you know, because the meshes are very large here, most of the codes can be run in, you know, high performance computing actually, okay. High performance, you know, the computing is required. I hope all of you people have accounts, right, in HPCA. See, all of you are having access to our HPCA, that Virgo cluster or something like that. Have you taken accounts?
So I don't still have an account.
See, now for this course, you know, you have to take a HPCE account, okay? So you can download a form. I think your guide has to sign, okay? So immediately, yes, they will give you. And I think now Virgo is, now Aqua cluster has come, a new machine has come, you know, installed in our supercomputer. So I think maybe next week, you know, that's what they told. They will allow others also to run on that one, okay? So you please take accounts in HPCE, Virgo or Aqua, you know, that cluster itself, okay? So this is the one most important thing. Okay. Now, so now coming back to our this one, you see. So these are most important, because you know these are large scale codes. Okay. So they run only on high performance machines. You can't run it on your desktops or, you know, the workstations kind of a thing. Maybe some small degree of freedom you can run, but not large scale actually. Okay. So please, you know, take account in this HPC itself. Now coming to the textbooks, okay. So coming to the textbooks, you know, what we will be doing is, you see. Okay. So one is, you see, I will be focusing this Heiner Eagle. Okay. So this is a famous book. His courses are also available online. If somebody, you know, you can go to this website also. Computational Seismology. Okay. So this is, you know, this book, I think officially, you know, our library has bought this book also, Oxford University Press, and it is also available online, okay. Our TAs are there, like Meenakshi and others, they may send you this textbook itself, okay. Then other book is this one. So another textbook is, you know, this Craig actually, okay. So Craig Jr. and Kurbila. So these are the others, and the title is, you know, Fundamentals of Structural Dynamics. Okay. Uh, So these are the two books, you know, which we'll be using in this course. Now, when it comes to random vibrations, we will see if we can finish, you know, we will take some standard textbooks on random vibration, okay? So one is Nigam, okay? So this is a famous book, Nigam, you know, on random vibrations. Or Y.K. Lin is there, okay? So this is also another book, Y.K. Lin, Probabilistic Structural Dynamics. Okay. So all these textbooks are available, you know, in our library. I think soft copies are there. So you can get these books, you know, and you can use it in this course itself, okay? So these are the textbooks, and there are many other reference books are there. You can go through, you know, several textbooks are there, you know, apart from these things itself, okay? And now coming to this evaluation, say, okay? Now since this is, right now, you know, we have not yet decided how to evaluate. So this is a 7,000 level course, okay? It is not like a core course kind of a thing or something. So core course means we have to have conduct, you know, quiz one, quiz two, and then end sum kind of a thing. And we have a fixed weightages, but now this is a mostly, you know, research based kind of a course. So we will have one mid sum kind of a thing, okay? And we will be having, you see, the end sum kind of a thing. And then, you know, we will have some, you see, assignments, and then, you know, the projects. You followed. So these things will be there. Now, how much will be the weightage, you know, we will decide after some time. Right now, I myself, I don't have clarity. So, you know, based on our discussions, we can see. And all the exams now, since the course itself is online, so the exams are all open book exams, okay? There is no closed book kind of a thing, okay? So now you followed, right? It's an open book kind of a thing, and whatever you submit, you know, I will use it for grading. Irrespective, you know, we cannot police on, you know, each and everything. It's very difficult. So whatever you send in email, I will take it as official, and we will use it for grading actually. Okay, so this is the open book exams will be conducted. Okay, so one in mid sem, another one in end sem, then assignments and projects. So like once we finish this unit one, okay, essentially once we finish this unit one, say, we can have our mid sem. Then, you know, before we go to this, you know, unit two and unit three kind of a thing. Okay. So that is how, you know, the course is. Now, so I hope, right, things are, you know, so I think, you know, we have finalized the syllabus, then the textbooks, and then we see the evaluation actually. So now if some of you have any questions, you know, you can ask. Now on this syllabus, evaluation, textbooks. Now. So if you have any questions, you please ask me on this screen. So if there are no questions, then we will proceed for the course, okay, for the first one. And now our classes will be conducted in J slot, okay? It's a 3-credit course. So 2 J slots are there, I think 1 hour, 15 minutes kind of a thing. So today, I think 2 to 3:15 is the class. Then I think tomorrow also we have a J slot. That is from, you know, 3:25 to 4:40 actually, okay? So 2 classes are there. So today and tomorrow. So that is sufficient for this course. Okay, so is it clear? Yeah, so then I think you will so now we see we'll proceed for this one. Of course. Yeah. So now I said, so the starting point is in structural dynamics also, as well as in you know, this continuum mechanics. You said the starting point is, you know, this three-dimensional, you see, the wave propagation. So this is a fundamental thing. I think we will change that thing. Yes, it's very light. Now, so let us see this, you know, what is meant by wave propagation. Okay, so let us see this three-dimensional wave propagation. So now, you know, in your structural mechanics, okay, which you would have studied in the previous semester, you would have seen the equations of motion actually, okay? That is the principle of linear momentum, angular momentum, and other things you would have studied in your ASM course, that is advanced structural mechanics course. You know that, you know, in this course you would have studied whenever you take a continuum, say, okay? So you have 6 stresses. All of you know these things. stress is a tensor kind of a thing, then 6 strains, okay, then 3 displacements, okay. So these are the, you know, so 6 plus 6 is 12, 12 plus 3 is 15. So 15 unknowns are there, and then we have this 15 equations also. So now coming to these equations of motions here. The first one is, you see, the principle of, you know, the linear momentum. Okay. Yeah. So which is written in terms of stresses. Okay. So all of you know this one. So dou sigma, you know, ij by dou, you know, xi. No. So dou xij plus bi is equal to rho dou square ui by dou t square. Okay. So this is that, you know, the principle of linear momentum, that is the equation of motion we write in terms of stresses. Okay. So if you write this properly, xij. Okay. So this is your principle of linear momentum, which you can write in terms of stresses. And B say, so these are your body forces. Okay. So this is in, you know, your strength of, in your, you know, advanced structural mechanics, you would have seen these things. Okay. And now we have the strain displacement relations also. So now coming to the strain displacement, so we write, you know, epsilon ij. So this is half, you know, dou uy by dou xj plus, you know, dou uj by dou xi. So these are our strain displacement relations itself, okay. Then we have stress strain relations also. So now coming to the stress strain relations, you say. So your sigma ij, okay. So you all know these things. So delta ij, epsilon kk kind of a thing, plus 2 mu actually, okay, epsilon ij. So these are the equations. So now you see, so this is one, the principle of linear momentum is the first one. Then we have strain displacement relationships itself. Then we have, you know, the stress strain relations. Okay. So now if you see here, the principle of linear momentum, this gives you 3 equations. Okay. Whereas strain displacement relations, so there are 6 equations are there. Then your stress strain relations, so they are also 6 actual. Okay. So 6 plus 6 plus 3, that is 12 plus 3 is 15 equations are there. And now the unknowns also, if you say 6 stresses, 6 strains, 3 displacements actually, okay. So totally, finally you are having this, the 15 unknowns are there. And then you see the 15 equations actually, okay. The problem is, you know, very well posed. Okay. So these derivations and other things you would have studied in your structural mechanics course, okay. And now, apart from this, we also have, you know, what we call as rotations actually in continuum mechanics. Okay, so they are nothing but, you see, the derivatives of displacements. They are not like independent, you know, degree of freedom. No. So this you can write as, you see, omega x kind of a thing. You write as half, you know, dou u y by dou z minus, you see, dou u z by dou y. Okay. Then you have rotation in y direction. So this is half, you know, dou uz by dou x minus, you see, dou ux by dou z kind of a thing. And then you have, you know, sigma z. So this is, you know, half dou ux by dou y minus, you see, dou uy by dou x actually. So these are the rotations, okay. The rotations are not independent degree of freedom. They are nothing but the derivatives of, you see, the displacements itself actually, okay. And now when you combine these 3 equations, say, see, like for example, this equation is written in terms of, you see, the stresses, okay. Now stresses are related to strains, okay, through this expression. And now strains are related to displacement. So you substitute epsilon in this expression, say, you can directly get the equation between stresses and displacements actually, okay. And now after you substituting this expression, you substitute sigma ij in this equation, okay, that is in this original equation. So you can eliminate the stresses and strains. You can write the equation of equilibrium in terms of, you see, the displacements itself, okay. So which we also known as Navier-Stokes equations kind of a thing we have. So displacement equations of equilibrium, okay. So the displacement equations of equilibrium can be written. So substitute, just epsilon here, you know, the, all those things if you do. So you can write this as lambda plus mu. Now, dou epsilon, this is a volumetric strain by dou x, plus mu del square, you know, ux kind of a thing is equal to rho, dou square ux by you see, dou t square. So you get one equation. The second one will be like this. Dou epsilon v by dou y plus mu del square, you know, uy. So rho dou square uy by dou t square. Okay. And the third one will say, so lambda plus mu dou epsilon z, this is dou v by dou z plus mu del square, you see, uz is equal to rho dou square, you know, uz by dou t square actually. Okay. So these are the three displacement equations of equilibrium. Sometimes, you know, people also call this as, you know, Navier-Stokes. Okay, so equations of equilibrium also. Some textbooks, you know, they write like this also. Okay, so this is just nothing. You substitute strains in terms of stresses and stresses in terms of displacements. Finally, you will get these three equations. And where your epsilon V say, whatever I have written. So this is known as volumetric strain. So which can be written as, you see, dou ux by dou x plus dou uy by dou y plus, you see, dou uz by dou z actually. So these are our fundamental equations, okay, for this one. And your del squares is your Laplacian, you know, the operator. Yeah. So this you can write as, you see, dou square by dou x square plus, you know, dou square by dou y square plus, you know, dou square by, you see, dou z square. So this is your Laplacian operator. And lambda and mu say they are nothing but, you know, the Lames constants. Okay. So this is how, you see, the equations have been, you know, derived actually. So now if you see here, all these equations, you say, they are all PDEs. You followed, right? So if you observe them, so they are nothing but, you see, the partial differential equations actually. Okay. And now these equations also, if you see, they are basically, you see, coupled kind of equations, we say. You followed. So these are all coupled PDEs. The reason is, you know, the like this. So this is an equation for ux, this is an equation for uy, this is an equation for uz. But epsilon v contains, you know, dou ux, uy, uz itself actually. Okay. So these three are not like, you know, separate equations for ux, uy and uz. And basically ux, uy, uz, all three are coupled actually. Okay. Due to this, you know, the epsilon v, which comes in the, that is in the first term. So this contains ux, uy, uz. So automatically, you know, so these are all coupled PDEs, we say. Suppose if we had only the equation contains only ux, this equation contains only uy, this equation contains only uz, say. So then, you know, these are all uncoupled PDEs, we can say. But since they are all same, you know, they all include each and every term. So we also call them as, you know, the coupled PDEs actually. Okay. And these equations also, when you see, there is no, you cannot make any physical meaning actually. Okay. So there is no physical meaning you can give for this, you know, the equations. So now what we do is to give a physical meaning, say, we do like this actual, okay? So we use some, you know, the simple algebra. Okay, so we use some small, if you make this algebraic operations, say. So if you do dou by dou x of, you know, suppose if you derive, if you call this equation as, you know, this is equation one, this is, you know, the equation two, and if you take this as equation three, okay, these three displacement equations. So if you do like this, so dou by dou x, say, of, you know, the equation one plus, say, so dou by dou y of equation two plus dou by dou z actually of equation three. Now, so when you do this summation, you see, so you get nice, you know, the expression. That is, you see, the first one will be, say, lambda plus mu dou square ey by dou x square. Okay, so if you see this first equation, so when you differentiate this with respect to x, once again, say, already x is there, so you will get second derivative actually. Okay, plus mu and Laplacian operator, say, dou square ux by using dou x. Okay, sorry, there is no x here, square here. Dou ux by dou x. So right hand side also is rho dou square is ux by dou x dou t square, actually the first one. Then similarly, so the second one, so lambda plus mu by dou y square, now the second one, so mu del square dou uy by dou y is equal to rho dou square uy by dou y into dou t square, the second one. The third equation, say you differentiate with respect to z, so dou square epsilon v by dou z square plus mu del square, say dou uz by dou z is equal to rho dou square uz by dou z into dou t square. So these are the three equations. When you differentiate the first one with respect to x, second one with respect to y, the third one with respect to z, and now you sum up all these three. Okay, so when you sum up all these three, so now you can see here, so when I add these terms, so epsilon v is common in all these things, so you will be having, you see, and then here dou ux by dou x mu del square is same actually in all these three. So what happens is, you know, dou ux by dou x plus dou y by dou y plus dou uz by dou z comes, and now if you see what is dou ux by dou y and dou uz by dou y, say, so this is nothing but your volumetric strain. Okay, so this term comes here, so now so and epsilon v is also there here, so this becomes finally, so lambda plus mu del square epsilon v. Okay, so why Laplacian is, because here dou square by dou x square, dou square by dou y square term is there here, then dou square by dou z square is nothing but Laplacian here, and then you sum up these two also, so mu into you followed, so del square epsilon v, okay, is equal to is a rho dou square by dou t square. Now here also, if you see this expression, so dou ux by dou x, dou y by dou y plus dou uz by dou z, so this once again, you see, you will get a volumetric strain actually. Okay, so this R, you can write this same thing as lambda plus 2 mu. Okay, so del square epsilon v is equal to rho dou square epsilon v by dou t square actually. So this is you followed, right, the famous the wave equation we say actually. And now you see this equation has a physical meaning. What is the physical meaning of this? Can anybody say? See, can anybody identify what is the physical meaning of this one? See, what is here? What is this here? This is a volumetric strain. You followed, right? So our volumetric strain, volumetric stress, they are all related to pressure kind of a thing actually. Okay, so you can say this is a physical meaning, you can give for volumetric changes in the deformations. Okay, but if you look at these original equations, you say these are the three, you cannot make any physical meaning out of these equations. Okay, because they are all coupled and you cannot understand nice physical meaning we cannot give. But when you slightly rearrange these equations, you say, you can give nice thing here, and you can also write this equation as like this, del square epsilon v, you can also write this as 1 by vp square, okay, dou square epsilon v by dou t square actually, where your vp, that is nothing but square root of is lambda plus 2 mu by rho. Okay, the p wave velocity r, you see, the volumetric waves, you follow, right, it goes actually. Okay, so this is a a nice equation, you see, a very famous you followed the equation in the computational mechanics, in the structural mechanics. So this is also known as, you see, scalar wave equations. You followed a scalar wave equation kind of a thing, and the wave velocity, say, is given by this the vp kind of a thing. So these are the famous equation. Now here, so this is one equation. Now if you do one more algebraic term, say like for example dou by dou y, okay, of equation 1 minus dou by dou x of equation 2. Okay, so these are our equations. Equation 1, 2, 3 are this one only. So now the first equation, so you differentiate with respect to y, then the second equation we differentiate with respect to x, and we subtract 1 minus 2. Now what happens? So when I do with respect to y, say I will be having dou square epsilon v by dou x dou y I will get. Now here I will get dou u x by dou y. Then here also I will get dou u x by dou y kind of a thing. Now here we are differentiating with respect to x. So dou square epsilon v by dou x will come. Then dou u v by dou x will come, and dou u y by dou x itself will come. Now here what happens, the first term? See, when I subtract this minus this, so lambda plus mu is common. The first one becomes dou square epsilon v by dou x dou y. This also becomes dou square epsilon v by dou y dou x, because dou x dou y both of them are same. When I subtract this from this, say, so this automatically gets cancelled actually. So I will be having only these two terms will be there in our calculations. So if you write this expression, say, okay. So if you do this one, or the first equation, say lambda plus mu, dou square epsilon v by dou x dou y plus mu del square dou u x by dou y is equal to rho dou square u x by dou y dou t. Then the second one, say, is lambda plus mu dou square epsilon v by dou y dou x plus mu dou u y by dou x is equal to rho dou square u y by dou x into dou t. So these are the two things. So now this minus this. So when I subtract, you see, so this term you followed it gets cancelled. So you will be remaining with these two. So if you rearrange, say, okay. So you have mu into del square now dou u, sorry. So what happens is, you see, dou u x by dou y minus dou u y by dou x is equal to rho, and dou by dou t if you put outside. So you have dou u x by dou y minus dou u y by dou x. Okay, so this is how you see it comes. And now what is this term? What is this term?
So what is dou x omega z?
So that is nothing but the rotation in you see the z direction. Okay, anyway 2 gets cancelled here, so finally you see you can write this as mu del square omega z actual is equal to rho dou square dou by this dou z dou square. You can also write like this, this expression. Already dou t square is there, right? I'm sorry. This becomes dou cube actually. Okay. So because dou t square is there, I forgot in this expressions. Yes, because already t square term is there here. Okay. So now finally, you see, you can write this expression as, t square. Okay, so this equation, you see, which comes in terms of the rotation actual. Okay, so or you can also write this as del square omega z is equal to 1 by vs square dou square omega z by dou t square, where your vs is nothing but root of mu by rho kind of a thing. Okay, so this is you will get, you see, this equation for omega z actual. Now, in a similar fashion, say, you can try with the variety of cases. Say, like dou by dou z of equation 1 minus dou by dou x of equation 3. Okay. So, if you do this one, so you will get, another special equation for another rotation actual. Omega y. So, this becomes 1 by vs square. Dou square, omega y by dou t square. Okay. Now, if you do another combination, say, you will get for x itself actually. Dou square, x by dou t square. Okay. So, you can derive equations like this actually. So, now these equations are in terms of rotations. other equation is in terms of, you see, the volumetric strain, you know, the kind of a thing actually, okay? So now these equations say, okay, so finally we are having two equations. One is a del square epsilon V, just to summarize. So 1 by Vp square, and then you see dou square epsilon V by dou t square. So this you have got one equation, and then we are having another equations, you see, del square omega z is equal to 1 by Vs square, and dou square omega z by dou t square, and then you see del square 1 by Vs square x by dou t square, then you see we have del square this one by 1 by Vs square by dou t square, okay? So these are the fundamental equations actually, okay? Instead of solving that Navier-Stokes equations, we can solve, you see, these equations actually, okay? So which can be obtained from Navier-Stokes. Now this is known as, you see, a scalar wave equation actually, okay? Whereas these three are known as, you see, vector equations. Because there are three components, are the rotation in x direction, rotation in y direction, and rotation in z direction. So now instead of solving the, you know, the equation in terms of displacements, physically, you know, it doesn't have any meaning, but this is, you know, much meaningful than the original equations, okay? And the other advantage of these three equations, these equations are, you know, uncoupled actually. Okay, so uncoupled PDE. See, the meaning is, you know, this equation is explicitly for epsilon V. Now, this equation is explicitly for sigma Z actual, okay? And this equation is explicitly for sigma X. So, there is no coupling, like the equation for sigma X doesn't contain sigma Z or sigma Y kind of a thing. So, these are all uncoupled, whereas the original equations are all coupled kind of a PDEs actual, okay? So now in mathematics, you say there is one, you know, the fundamental theorem is there actually, okay? Based on that theorem also, you can derive these equations. The fundamental theorem is there, okay, in vector calculus. Okay. So which we call as, you know, the Helmholtz theorem. So we have got from simple algebra, but there is a mathematical, you know, there is a strong thing is there. So which says, you know, any vector, say, okay, you can represent as, you see, del phi plus, you know, del cross, you see, psi kind of a thing. Okay, this is a fundamental theorem itself, where your phi is, you know, a scalar potential. Okay, where your psi is nothing but, you see, a vector potential. So which means it has components psi 1, psi 2, and then psi 3 kind of a thing. Okay, so your del phi, say, okay, so it indicates you know, your gradient of a scalar. Okay, so gradient of a scalar kind of a thing, whereas you know, this one is you see, gradient of a scalar kind of a thing, and this quantity is a del cross psi. It is basically, you see, a curl of a vector. So this is irrotational. Okay, so this is a irrotational thing. So you can decompose into this thing, okay? So now you know, so you can write this based on this Helmholtz decomposition, say you can write any displacement actually. So if you take you know, u of x, okay, so you can write this expression as you know, dou phi by dou x, and then you are a del phi, sorry, or you know, if you want to write, say, so if you write like properly, so as all of, you know, if you are having any scalar quantity, say, so when you take gradient of a scalar, what do you get? You people remember, what does gradient does? See what gradient does there. Few people are there. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Now, what does the gradient of a scalar?
It will be a vector.
It is a basically a vector actual. Okay, then the curl of a vector, of course, that is also vector kind of a thing. So now we, you know that expansion, right? So gradient of a scalar, say dou phi. Yeah. So how do you write dou phi
by
dou
x?
Dou z into uz kind of a thing. And whereas you are a del cross phi, say, okay, is nothing but determinant of this matrix, all of, you know, ex, ey, then ez. So dou by dou x, dou by dou y, and this is dou by dou z kind of a thing. And you have ux, uy, and uz. Sorry, this is psi x, psi y, psi z kind of a thing. So this is a curl. So now you know you can club these two. So now you can write your ux as you know dou phi by dou x, which comes from the gradient of a scalar, plus dou psi z by, you see, dou y, minus dou psi y by, you see, dou z actual. So this is your displacement ux in terms of these potentials. Okay. Now similarly, say your uy can be written as, you see, so now your uy, it can also be written as, you know, dou phi by dou y. So this becomes, you see, dou phi by dou y plus dou psi y by dou, sorry, dou psi, dou x by dou z minus, you see, dou psi z by, you see, dou x kind of a thing. Then uz is dou phi by dou z plus, you see, dou psi z by dou y, dou x minus, you see, dou psi y, so dou psi x by dou z actual, so dou y. Okay. Now, so this is x by dou y, and this is dou psi. So this is dou psi. No, so this will be dou psi y, but dou x minus dou psi y by dou y. Okay, so these are the, you see, the display relation from Helmholtz decomposition theorem. Say you can write ux, uy, and uz in terms of potentials actual. Okay, so if you substitute these potentials, you know, in the wave equations, if you substitute, these equations, okay, in the Navier-Stokes equations, say. Displacement, you know, equations of equilibrium. So now you know automatically you get four equations. One is you know del square phi is 1 by vp square dou square phi by dou t square. You will get one equation like this. Then other equations will be dou del square is 1 by vs square dou square psi x by dou t square. Okay, and other equation will be del square psi y 1 by vs square dou square psi y by dou t square. And then the other equation will be, you know, del square psi z is equal to, you see, 1 by vs square dou square psi z by dou t square actually. So you will get, you see, once again, you know, these are four sets of equations actually from Helmholtz decomposition also. Okay, but mathematically when you do this operation, say, it looks as if four equations are there. But now if I do by this technique, you know, which we did previously, like, you know, differentiating, and then you also will get the same type of equations actual. Okay, so this we have done from some algebra kind of a thing. So here mathematically, you know, you can prove that from decomposition theorem, that whenever you are having a vector field, so you can split into two pieces. And if you substitute, you know, you can derive this set of equations. So this is, once again, as already I told you, a scalar potential. So scalar wave equation, we say. Okay. and these are all, you see, the vector, you know, the wave equations. Because it has three components, psi x, psi y, and psi z. Okay. Now, apart from that, say one more equation comes is, you know, because of, you know, dou psi x by dou x plus dou psi y by dou z plus dou psi z, say, by dou z. So, this also is equal to zero. So, which means it comes from a mathematical thing, the divergence of curl, say, of your psi is equal to zero. Because of this criteria, you will get this fourth equation also. Okay. But anyway, this is a small minor thing. Now, Vp is equal to, you know, so root of lambda plus 2 mu by rho. And Vs is equal to root of, you see, mu by rho kind of a thing. So, these are the equations actually. So, now, your displacement equations of equilibrium, you see, they are in terms of displacement. There are three equations, but those three are coupled PDEs actually. But by using this Helmholtz decomposition, say, we can obtain, you know, uncoupled equations. But you have to pay a price actually. The original equations are three, but you are having four uncoupled PDEs. Of course, these three are not independent. They are related through this, you know, the expression itself. Okay. So now generally in continuum mechanics, what we do is, instead of solving Navier-Stokes equations, say, we solve these equations actually. Okay. That is the scalar wave equations and vector wave equations. Once you know phi, psi x, psi y, psi z from these equations, say, okay. So you can substitute here. You will get back your stresses. Once you know the survey, you will get back with the displacements. Once you know displacements, you can use strain displacement equations to find out strains. And then from strains, say, you can even calculate to see the stresses itself. That is how you see we do it in mechanics. Okay. So now, you know, in this course, say, what we are going to do in this course is, these are our basic equations. That's a scalar wave equation, vector wave equations. Now, you know, for closed form solutions, you can obtain for some special cases. You followed. So the closed form, closed form solutions can be derived for some special cases. Are possible. Okay. For some special, you see, the cases itself. But in general, say, getting a closed form thing is becoming, you followed, right, a very, very difficult kind of a thing. So in this course, what we will do is, we will solve these equations. Solve these wave equations, okay? By, you see, the numerical methods. Okay? So this is how, you see, we are going to do in this course. So these are the fundamental equations. So what I suggest you is, all of you, you please derive once again these equations with your own hand, okay? So now once you are confident, or once you are clear about these four equations, you know, then the course is nothing actually, okay? So this course, you know, we are not going to do anything. Simply these four fundamental equations, say, how to solve using the numerical methods, we are going to discuss in this course itself. And these four equations are more generalized kind of a thing. See, in structural dynamics, you know, or in our, you know, that strength of materials, we use that plane sections remain plane, and we derive this flexural vibration of a beam, the shear vibration of a beam, all those problems, say, they are nothing but, you know, one-dimensional kind of a thing. So now if this equation, if you neglect one some dimensions, say, these equations itself collapse to your, those equations itself. So if you know how to solve these four equations, say, other problems are, you know, very, very easy to solve. Okay, so these are how you see. So now in this course, we will see what is the speciality of this equation. Okay. Of this, you know, the equation, we will see what's the importance or something, and then how to do this numerical methods actually. Okay, so how do we discretize, you know, the element size and others, we are going to see. Now, generally in our, static FEM actually. Okay, so some of you would have done this finite element method course, all this course itself. So element size, generally, you see, you can choose, you know, whatever you want, and then as the size of element decreases, say, or the number of elements increases, your solutions converge or something like that, it happens. But when the same FEM, you know, when it comes to dynamics actually, okay? So when you're solving a dynamic problem, then, you know, you have, you know, so many issues are there. So this element size, it depends on, you know, your wave velocities, you know. It depends on wave velocities and so many, you know, the complications will be there. And this also depends on your, you know, the step size actually. Okay. that is a dt, you know, the time integration, whatever you are going to choose your dt. So all those, you know, stability issues, you know, so many things may come into picture. And when you are really solving a wave propagation problem, you know, sometimes, you know, having a finer mesh will give worst result than, you know, the coarse elements actually. Okay, so the, in our FEM, you would have studied that as size of the element decreases, your FEM converges to a, you know, the closed form solution. But the same problem when you do it in a dynamics, that the load is a dynamic case or something, so you can have, you know, a large element size may give a better result than, you know, a small element, if all right, because there are so many issues are there, your wave velocities and then your DTs, whatever you are going to use in the discretization. So this matters, you see, a lot in, you know, this wave propagations. Okay. So now I think you followed it. So with this, you know, the introduction, say, okay. So we, so now I see, so if you have any doubts, you can ask me on these wave equations right now. See, all of you are there or sleeping?
Yes, sir.
You're sleeping. So now if you have anything, you ask me. So these are the fundamental equations for our course, okay? So if you have any questions or something, you can ask me. So if there is a, please tell me.
So it is clear only. We understood.
You understood. I want to from others also. See, generally in your structural dynamics, you followed, right? You would have studied single degree, then multiple degree of freedom systems. Then you would have studied these continuous systems, okay? Where you see vibration, shear vibration and others. So they are all very, very small problems actually, okay? So if you know how to solve four wave equations, other equations will be, you know, very, very easy for you to solve. So, you know, see, there are, you know, variety of ways to teach a course. One is you start from small problem, you come to a big problem, or you take a big problem and then, you know, from there itself, you see, you can understand, you know, step by step, where small problems also becomes as a, you know, what you can say, offshoot kind of a thing actually, okay? So our full course will be using this equation. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So anyway, I will stop here the today's class. Okay. So all of you, please download the textbooks. You know, our Meenakshi has. She can send you the textbooks itself. So you please download these textbooks and you please go through. Then all of you have to go to that CIG, that computational infrastructure in geodynamics. Please download all the softwares also, that essentially the SPECFEM software and PyLith software. Then you please take account in HPCE. Okay, that is more you know, required actually, okay, for this course. So is it fine?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, then. So we'll continue in our tomorrow's class, okay? So we'll continue tomorrow, you know, I think 3:45, 3:15, right, the classes. 3:25 class, 3:25 we will continue tomorrow's class, okay? Okay.